Marathon's last, yeah, I've done it tonight, I've been doing fine.
A deck area is the ideal opportunity to extend your living space. Could be the perfect barbecue spot, or simply just somewhere to chuck a couple of sunglasses. Decking is also ideal around children's play pits and pastures jutting over a pool. Decking would also be the perfect solution to a garden problem. You might have an area of the garden which is damp and shady, where the grass isn't growing very well, why not have a deck there for table and chairs? First things first, gotta pick the right site. Now, we're building a deck here which ultimately just sits flat on the ground, so ideally don't site something like that up in the lowest point of the garden where all the water collects. Admittedly, the frame is treated, but it's just not going to last as long this way. Of course, if you are thinking of building a deck where there's lots of standing water, you just need to pop some legs on it. Do consider the view from your deck. That's quite important. You don't want to position it somewhere where you'll be nosing in on the neighbours or they'll be staring up at you. If you're going to build a deck next to a house, a few things to consider there. Firstly, you don't want to cover up any air bricks, and nor do you want to comp or building your deck above it. And it sounds a bit silly, but make sure you open the doors too. In urban gardens, drains are inevitable, but they're easy to deal with. Just make sure that you build a little hatch in the deck, which you can then simply remove to access the drain easily. If you want to build a deck around a tree, and it really does look lovely, just make sure that you leave lots and lots of room for the trunk to thicken up and for it to sway in the wind. Now, you don't need to be a carpenter to build a deck. You just need some basic skills. Just remember to plan a little bit before you start and do a few measurements as you go along. And of course, it does help to have an extra pair of hands too.
We're laying this decking, which has already been pressure treated against decay, but these cut ends we're going to seal with some end grain preserver.
Don't forget, always use gloves when handling grain preserver.
The next thing we need to do is work out how big the deck area will need to be, and these are the chairs and the table that we're going to be using.
Now, as a general guide, to accommodate a standard size table and chairs, you need about 9 square metres of space. But here's a good tip. If you've got a dining set or a sun lounge, just pop those in position and use these as a guide to the size of the deck, making sure, of course, that you've got plenty of room to pull the chair back so that you don't pitch over the edge. Before you commit yourself, it's a really good idea to do a dry run. Lay out the frame, lay out the boards which go on top. And this way you can just see if the whole thing fits and where any cuts might be. Right, the frame. That's simple, really. What we've got here is treated 6x2 timber, which we run down the outside, and then we pop it through the middle as well at various spacing for joists to take the weight. On the top, we then use the deck board, that's important here. These ones have got a grooved side, and they've got a smooth side. It's up to you which one you use. I actually prefer the smooth side, because it's more comfortable underfoot. And importantly, remember that the joists need to run in the opposite direction to the boards for strength.
Of course, you need to leave a gap between the boards of 3 millimetres for rainwater to drain away. And a really good way to do this is to use a screw that's 3 millimetres wide as a spacer.
Right, well, we're at the end here now, and importantly, we're factoring in the width of the back board, which is going to be a face board to hide our frame all the way round. Now, this may seem like a bit of a faff having a dry run like this, but it really does pay dividends in the long run, because look, exactly as I feared, we've ended up with a horrible little sliver at the front here. So that would mean that we would have to cut a board down, which wouldn't really fix properly, and it would kind of so options. We could either extend the distance between each board just ever so slightly, or we can come in and we can cut the frame down a little so that we end up with a nice full board just like that.
The timber used for the frame is standard treated 6x2, which you can pick up from most B&Q stores. Lengths. So with the overall size of your deck in mind, buy those lengths, which mean as little cutting as possible, on the day. Once you've got the frame size, you'll need to work out how many deck boards you'll need to cover the top. Factor in the actual width of the deck board, and then add on another 3 millimetres for each gap. Carter and I have almost finished marking out where we're going to remove the board and allow Deckard to go. Now, we've used building blocks and wooden pegs, but only if you could do garden pegs in string. To check that we've actually marked the space out completely square, what we use two diagonal measurements are the same, it'll be square. Of course, you could also actually make the frame itself, and if it's square, pop that into position, and simply cut it out of it. With that. So, we've marked out where our frame is going to go. And here I've just got a simple edging iron, which I'm using to cut alongside the string lines. And then once I've done that all the way round, I'll then use a spade to lift up the turf. If you haven't got an edging iron, you can just use a spade. The depth of the turf that we're going to remove, no more than 2 inches. We've shown you how to make a basic deck which sits directly on the ground. And we can do that here because the ground is really, really firm. Of course, it's really important that the whole site is level. And to do that, I've just got a board here with a spade level on top, and I'm working my way over, knocking off any high bits, not filling any low ones, which you may find you can use a spade too. Oh, and don't forget to remove any large stones as you go. To stop any weeds coming through the decking, we've put down this weed control fabric. Make sure there's a decent overlap at the edges. This cuts out all the light, but it still allows rainwater to drain through.
It's so much better, because black plastic work isn't permeable, so you'll have standing water underneath your deck, and that's not a good idea.
We're just covering the fabric with, well, any old gravel, bringing the height up to just below the surrounding lawn. Slightly knee pad for this bit, just cutting the frame to size. So, mark off where we want. And then using a square, going to pop a line in, which we can then cut to. We've already got the 4 pieces of timber, which will make up the outside of our frame, already cut. And now what we need to do is that we need to put 2 pilot holes in the ends of 2 of those boards, so that we can fix the corners together.
And then we're going to use a countersink drill bit so the coach screw goes in and sits far back enough so that when we put the facing board onto the front, it sits nice and flush.
And these are particularly important because they will bear the weight and distribute it evenly, that is when you're sitting on top of course. Now, the distances between the joints, they do vary, but 400 millimetres from centre to centre is absolutely fine. And once you've got it all lined up, up in your end, and we'll just pop round to the front, and pop our coach screws in. We've already cut our deck boards to the size that we want, so that we can simply pop them on the top and screw them down. Just keep things nice and simple. One thing that you might come across, especially if your deck is bigger than the length of a board, is you have to put a join in. If you do, make sure that the join sits in the middle of the joint, so that way you can get 2 really good fixing points. Then the next board that goes on, keep it as a full one and stagger the joint so you then get your join again, and then you get a full board, and then you join. Just makes it look nice and neat. Just pops in some pebbles around the front for a nice decorative finish. Now this is of course your basic ground level deck, but there are loads of different variations with which you can do at home. You might want to put some legs on it to raise it up, a hand rail on the front if you're worried about people falling off, maybe even some lights to turn it into more of a decorative feature. And there are lots of different ways of customising your deck too. Here we'll just use a simple natural stain, but if you want something bigger, bolder and brighter, there are a range of colours with which you can buy in store. There are many different materials available too.